Welcome back, students. In this lesson, I'm going to teach you your first minor scale, B minor two octaves. But of course, I'll explain everything about how minor scales work on the violin so you can actually play them all. This lesson is part of my free beginner course. And if you're thinking, I have no idea what you mean, then watch this YouTube playlist. There you can find all previous lessons that take you from scratch up to playing your first violin concerto with three movements. It's been an awesome journey. And yeah, if you're following along this course, then really let me know in the comments how you are doing and what's your progress and what you liked most learning in this course. And if you're completely new here, I'm Zlata. I live in Holland. I'm a professional violinist turned stay-at-home mom, sharing my art and skills online. And I have no idea how far I will take this beginner course. Lesson 100. Less than 1,000. Well, I sure know that if not enough people like and subscribe, I might stop it because, you know, it doesn't make sense to teach my camera and my wall to play the violin. Would be a little bit embarrassing. So thanks for supporting my work by subscribing to my channel. Now, how does a minor scale work? Well, you at least know how many sharps and flats it has by going from the major scale. So for example, if you have C major that doesn't have any sharps and flats, then if you go two notes down to A minor, then you get A minor. And it also doesn't have sharps and flats. And in this lesson, we're going to learn the B minor scale. Now, how do we know how many sharps or flats that scale has? Well, we have for that a circle of fifths. So I have here my nice violin fingering chart in which you can see all positions and spots to put your fingers on the violin, all possible notes in sheet music, and also a circle of fifths. Now you can download that for free at violinlounge.com/poster, I believe. You can also order a printed version if you prefer that. Well, now let's take a look at this circle of fifths. There we see, we just talked about C major and A minor. Now we see here B minor, so that corresponds with two notes higher, D major, okay? And that has two sharps. And we already played with two sharps in D major, of course, so it's not too difficult. But there's a little weird thing about minor scales. There are actually three types of them. And the major scale was just, you know, like that. And of course, in pieces you'll find alterations and everything because, you know, not everything is all the time in that specific key. A composer moves through different keys in music. Now we have the harmonic minor and the melodic minor. And in harmonic minor, you just put a sharp right before the seventh note of the scale. So for example, if we move in a scale from B to B, then we've got that A as the seventh note right before that B, and we just put a sharp, so we make it a semitone higher. But in violin playing, certainly for the coming time that you're not playing chords and stuff very much, you don't see harmonic minor that much. You mostly see melodic minor, and that means that in the ascending scale, so going up, you make the sixth and the seventh note a semitone higher. And when you have a descending scale, so when you go down from high to low, then you just have the normal notes as by the sharps and flats that this scale has. Okay, so how does that look like when you are playing this? We start on the B. So we have that C sharp with which it's a high third finger, and we already had that before in this course, I believe in Le Vie en Rose. And then of course we have that D, that is the same as the open D string, so you can also use an open D string there. And then E, F sharp, so a high second finger. And as we are going up, we make that sixth note, so the G, we make that a G sharp, so a semitone higher. And then we also make that A a semitone higher, and you can play that either, so we already have this, with a high fourth finger, or you can play it as if it is a B flat. We already had that, I believe, in one of the Pracht songs that we learned. And you can just play a low first finger. Because the low first finger is the same note as the high fourth finger. You see? And then you're thinking, what's the difference between a B flat and an A sharp? Well, technically, on the piano, it's exactly the same key. So a pianist doesn't make a difference between an A sharp and the B flat, okay? So we say, as musicians, that it's enharmonically the same. Right? And on the violin in the future, as we will learn more about advanced intonation, then sometimes the A sharp and the B flat are a little bit different. For example, if you are playing this leading tone to the, and sorry, I had my whole music education in German and in Dutch. So if I don't get the English term right here and there, then yeah, excuse me for that. But this seventh tone of the minor scale that leads to the B. So for example, if you play that B minor scale, that A sharp really wants to go to the B. So it sounds better if you play it relatively high. But that's something of a lot later. By the way, if you are using a tuner to practice this, like the D'Addario Micro Tuner, I often recommend, made a video about it, probably a link to it. And then you have the piano tuning. Well, if you hear a piano playing, then that's quite a lot in tune. So if you can play in tune like that, then you've already come a long way on the violin. And after that, you can learn the more subtle things of intonation. I hope I don't confuse you too much with this, but I thought it was important to mention that intonation is relative in a way, and that as violinists we use different tuning systems. I am planning to shoot a video on that, by the way, to explain all about this, but here we're just going to play a simple two-octave B minor scale, okay? So we had it in two octaves, and we just played the first octave, okay? So we're now going to play the higher octave. So we're going from the B, and we have C sharp there, so it's a high second finger, and a D and the E, which is the same as the open E string, and F sharp, and then we come to the sixth note, which usually was a G. Now it's a G sharp, so it's a high second finger. And then the seventh note, we make that a semitone higher. It's an A sharp, high third finger. And then right next to that is the B. And then on the way back, we just have a G and an A, okay? So we have a normal third finger. So put that third finger back in its place. Low second finger, because it's a G. And that's right next to the normal first finger, which is an F sharp. E. A, so you can just play the open A string, which is not possible for the A sharp we are playing on the way up, okay? Normal G, F sharp right next to it, high second finger, E, B, but we do have that C sharp there, okay? So we have a high third finger on the G string. Alrighty, I hope I didn't confuse you too much with this. Just to make it all clear, here's my playing of the scale with piano accompaniment, and you can also see my fingers and the sheet music. Alright, here it goes. Thank you. want a really effective tool to practice your skills with, you can buy my sensational skills course in SoundSlice. And in this free beginner course, you already had some free samples from that course, so you can already see if it's something that is working for you. What you have in SoundSlice are the scales, and you can play the violin part, you can play the piano accompaniment, and you know, it's so effective to practice scales with piano accompaniment because it puts it in a musical context. And if you learn to intonate in that musical context, so to play in tune based on the musical surrounding, yeah, that's really something valuable. Certainly if you want to play together, but generally if you want to play in tune as well, of course. So if that speaks to you, then go to sensationalscales.com. You can loop them, you can repeat every bit you want, you can play it at any speed, you can add a metronome. There are violin tabs, violin visualization, everything. Just try the free stuff out, and maybe you can buy this course if you want it, of course, but you can perfectly, if you don't have the funds for that, you can perfectly use this lesson to practice it with, of course. Now, I hope everything is clear around those minor scales. We'll have more minor scales in the future lessons. Now, next week, we're going to play another Wohlfahrt etude, and that will prepare us for our second violin concerto, which is Reading Opus 35. It's very beautiful. It's in a beautiful minor key. It's very different from the Küchler Concertino. So I hope you stay with me to learn all that, and do that by subscribing to my channel. So I hope to see you in the next lesson. Bye bye!